Sunday papers and draw all of the eyes from every single strip onto a piece of paper, and then all of the noses, and then all the mouths, and then I would mix and match and draw my own characters. So in the Loud House, you can see it's kind of got a Sunday Funnies kind of feel to it.
About a week ago, we found out that Chris Savino was suspended from Nickelodeon due to negative actions in the past. This definitely was news that surprised everybody. I mean, Chris Savino didn't really seem like the type of guy to do this sort of stuff. However, the key word there was suspension, and that means that he could come back at some point in the future if Nickelodeon decides to bring him back. But a few days ago, the news was updated. He is not suspended anymore. Chris Savino has officially been fired from Nickelodeon and working on the Loud House. So this basically takes away any possibility of him coming back to the show. Things are going to be extremely different from now on. Keep in mind, the whole concept of the Loud House was made by Chris. He grew up in a large family and he wanted to make a show based on that life, but now it's just continuing without him, and the rest of the crew will have to make it work. In order to understand just how much the Loud House is gonna change, we should take a look at what exactly Chris Savino does on the show. Like, yeah, he's a creator, but what specifically did he do? He worked a lot on the story. He was a writer in many different episodes, he was a storyboard artist, an executive producer, he also directed a huge amount of episodes. So yeah, he had a huge role on The Loud House, and him being fired is definitely going to change the structure of the show. I think a lot of people are going to compare this whole situation to SpongeBob. The original creator Steven Hillenburg left after the first movie, and then the quality of the show got so much worse. Do I think The Loud House is going to end up going that same route? Possibly, but it isn't 100%. Chris Savino was fired, but Steven Hillenburg voluntarily left the show, and at the same time in the SpongeBob situation, a lot of new people came on the crew, so obviously the show would change. In The Loud House, I'm pretty sure Chris is the only one who's not working on the show anymore, and although he had probably the biggest influence of anyone working on the show, there's still everyone else on the Loud House crew that's been working on the previous episodes.
Hello. I'm Jordan Rosado, storyboard artist on The Loud House, Nickelodeon's one of their newest shows.
Hi guys, I'm Jordan Koch. I'm a storyboard artist here at Nickelodeon on The Loud House, and today we're going to be drawing a bunch of characters for you guys.
I hope that the show will make other kids more open to expressing how they feel.
We have a great sisterly friendship as it is. Like, we are like one big family.
That being said though, I still think we are going to be seeing some sort of change in future Loud House episodes. Chris just had such a huge influence over the entire show, and we know The Loud House as The Loud House mostly because of him. He's the one who thought of the concept, he wrote and directed many different episodes, he oversaw the whole operation that The Loud House went through. But will the quality of this show change because of Chris Savino being fired? Honestly, I'm not really sure. Time will really tell if this affects the quality of The Loud House in future episodes. The crew is now gonna have to work extra hard because they don't have the original creator with them anymore, and this is the guy who had the best idea of where to take the show in the future. So yes, it might be a challenge for the current crew to keep up with the quality of The Loud House, but I think it is still possible. If there's a new episode a few months down the line and it's really weird, you don't really expect it from previous Loud House episodes, chances are it's the new crew without Chris Savino experimenting and seeing what works. The change to the show might not be completely clear at first. It could be something as simple as tone, the type of lessons. With SpongeBob after the first movie, everything just felt a little bit different. There was no specific reason why the episodes got worse. They just had a different feel to it, resulting in a lot of people disliking those newer episodes, and something like that could potentially happen with the post-Savino era of The Loud House. We'll just have to wait and see what this means for the future of The Loud House, but things are definitely going to be different very soon.
We're watching.
Anyway, that's all for this video. Subscribe for more awesome cartoon videos. Give a thumbs up and comment below to let me know what you think. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.